Good day everyone. Tonight I'm going to teach you how to shade and how to paint the clothes. So now what you just need to do is go to your autodesk. Now this is the image we are working on. So now I'm going to teach you how to paint the clothes, how to the bear and the eye and the rest. So I'm going to teach you. Now the first thing you have to do is, now I told you that whenever you want to draw, you have to always create a new layer for your drawing. So now we are working on the nose and the cloth and other part too that we have not yet touched. So now this is my new layer. So now I'm going to take my pencil. So now the pencil we are going to use now is, the color we are to use is black. So I'm choosing my black color. This is my black. Then you click on this thing. Then you choose your pencil. So this is your paint brush. This is the paint brush we are going to make use of for our drawing. So now you draw the shirt. You follow the distance. You draw the shirt. Make sure you create a new layer for the shirt as you are drawing. Then you draw carefully. Make sure that the size of the pencil is 1.5. Take note. Then you continue with your drawing. Make sure you follow the clothes. So that's how you are going to do it. As you can see now, I'm following the shape of the clothes. Can you see the way I'm doing it? Can you see it? So you do the same thing too. You follow the shape of the clothes. Can you see the way I'm doing it? Can you see it? So now, the next thing you're going to do is to click on this small circle here. You click on it. Then you pick, there's what we call pick color. Now instead of you to be looking for color to use for the clothes and the rest, so it's better you pick color. Now the color of the clothes is a little bit brown, it's a little bit chocolate, I don't really know. But for you to be looking for the color, you just choose the color from the clothes and you start painting. Then you increase the size of the pencil, since the cloth is very big, you increase the size of the pencil so that when you are, it will be very easier, then you start painting. Sorry. Now I will create a new layer for the painting of the clothes. Now you start painting. Can you see the way I'm painting it? So that's how you are going to do it too. You paint. See the way I'm doing it? Can you see it? So that's how you are going to paint it too. So now you reduce the size of the pencil so that you'll be able to paint well. Control. So you continue with your painting. Can you see the way I'm doing it? Can you see? So you have to zoom out so that you'll be able to paint too. Can you see the way I'm doing it? So that's how you're going to do it. So follow the shape of the distance. Can you see it? That's how you're going to paint the shirt. Can you see the way I'm doing it? Keep on painting like that, gradually. You don't need to rush it. So just keep on painting. So you have to do a very neat job so that your client will be happy. And he or she will be able to give you another work. Can you see the way I'm doing it? And when you are shading, you have to be very careful when shading. Can you see the way I'm painting it? Can you see it? Can you see the way I'm doing it? Just gradually. It's a gradual process, so you don't need to rush at all. So you keep on painting. Keep on painting. Can you see where I paint? So now I'm done painting now. So now the next thing you are going to do is go to your layer, click on your layer. As you can see what I just painted now, can you see it? Can you see it? Now you click on it. Now let's change this normal to, let's change it to multiply and see. If you are not okay with this, the color of the cloth, you can choose anyone. Let's check linear dodge. Hey, I don't like this. Let's check overlay. Overlay is a little bit okay. Let's check soft light. The soft light. I think I prefer this. This one is okay by me. Can you see now? Can you see the difference? Can you see the difference? Now you create another layer for your bare and your high. So now the pencil you are going to use is black. So now the color we are to use is black. Then your this thing for the bear, make use of this air. Can you see this air? This air, yeah. You can see airbrush. So now make sure when you are drawing, you draw on a new layer. This is my new layer now. This is my own new layer. So now you draw the hair. Can you see the way I'm doing the hair? So follow the shape of the hair. Can you see the way I'm doing it? So make sure if you are shading the air, you don't shade other parts. You only shade this. You only shade the bear alone. So then you go back. Can you see it? So let's choose this. Let me show you this one. This is the stony brush air. So now you apply it a little. Stony brush. So as I'm applying the hair, you check, maybe it's okay, so that you're not going to... So, just check. So, you can change it to maybe multiply and see. If you are not okay with that, you can change it to soft light. I think this one is okay by me. The next thing you are going to do now is the high. So now And I told you, whenever you are drawing, you have to create another new layer. If you are drawing, create another new layer. As you can see now, I've created another new layer. Then you now choose your hair again. This is your pencil for your eyelashes. So you can do it to 1.0, depending on you. Then you draw. So if you are not okay with this kind of pencil, to me this pencil looks very sharp. So me, I would advise you should let's use the normal hair pencil. So let's use this. Let's use the hair. So make sure you are drawing on the new layer. Can you see my own layer? So now let's draw. Make sure it's not too much. So you follow the distance. You have to follow the distance. They will not go and draw another thing. Can you see it? So you follow it. Sorry. Apply your cleaner, clean it. Then you continue. You are making use of the hair. Can you see the way I'm doing it? So you are going to apply the same thing too. So this one is okay by me. So now the next thing we have to do now is how to shade. So I'm going to teach you how to shade. So now there are some part of the face that some places are dark, some places are light. So if you want to do it now, so as you can see now, these are our eyelashes. As you can see. So now there are some, then now to work, if you want to work on another this thing now, you create another new layer, then you work on the face. There are some places that need to be painting. So you if you are choosing it, you work on the new layer, then you go back, you choose your pencil, the instrument you are going to use for this. You are going to use this one, glow brush, for your painting. Now you go to your color, you come to your Copic. Now mind you, the last color we use for the painting is E23. Now you choose your E23. Now this is the color E23. Now you come to this side, you choose the darker part by shifting it a little bit, because there are some places are dark, so you have to shift it a little bit. So you apply some place that is dark. Like this place is somewhat dark. Some places are dark. So places that are dark, you have to paint it. So this is a little bit dark, you paint it. Sorry. Last color. So, face that are dark, you are going to paint it. So look for other places that are very dark and paint it. I see now. So that's how you are going to do it. Any place that is dark, you have to paint it. So now, then go back. Then the whitish side, you are going to paint it too. So now we are going to make use of yellow. Since the salt is a little bit yellow, let's use white 32. White 32. So this white 32, let's make it a little bit whitish. Some whitish side. I'll be thinking that this thing looks summer, but we have to apply it because so that the color, the face, the person face will come out. So that's why I see me doing all this. So this is reduce the opacity. So I think it's okay now. Then you smudge. So if you are smudging, you smudge on the first layer. This is the first layer, the former picture that we uploaded. You click on it, then you choose your smudging brush. This is your smudging brush. This is smudge round brittle brush. This is it. Then you go back, you smudge. So if you are smudging, you smudge carefully. So can you see the way I'm doing it? So we are smudging. Let's leave it at 3. It's okay now. It's okay by me now. Now, the next thing we have to do now, I think we are done with the picture like this. So, we are done with the picture. Now, you adjust this thing. The shading. Now, this shading now is, can just change it to soft light. So that the color, the sketching will not show. Anyway, so you can change this one to soft light. Soft light. That the sketching will not show too much. Anyway, you see sketching. This one to soft light, I've done that. Then the head, let's also change it to soft light. So now, I think it's okay by me. Let's check other parts too, so that the sketching will not be showing. So I think it's okay now. So now, I think we are done with our work now. It's okay by me like this. So now, at the mouth part too. The mouth part. Let's reduce the opacity. Let's reduce the hair. I think it's okay by me now. Then you save. If you want to save your work, you save it by reducing by zooming in. You zoom in like this. Now your work is saved now. I think it's saved now. Then you now go to your this thing, your Chrome. Type, you are going to type remove background, remove.bg. So now the thing is going to direct you to this point, to this place. Can you see it now? Then you upload your image. When you upload your image, you check the work you just do now, the recent work. So it's still loading. Let's wait. The network is a little bit poor here. I'm looking for the image. So Autodesk. So you look for Autodesk. Since we are making use of Autodesk, this app. Sketchbook rather. So now download. So I've downloaded my work now. So now, since I've downloaded my work, you go back to your PC lab. This is my PC lab. You click on it. Cancel. So this is what it's going to show you in your own PC lab. Then you click on delete. But by tomorrow, I'm going to do the introduction of PC lab. Then you now come to this direction. You click on this direction. You click on import image. So now, the image that you just downloaded, you click on it. Can you see it now? The mark. So you do the same too. So just do your own like this. Then next class, I'm going to teach you what to do next.